Welcome dear learners to Massive Open Online Course on Self-Learning Material Development. Dear learners, we just have learned the content organization and presentation in a self-learning material. Now, in this video, we will focus on how to write the content and present the content effectively. Dear learners, writing is the major means of presenting content matter in a self-learning material. With better writing skills, the author of self-learning material developer will be more confident in deciding what to include and in what order. In this way, it saves the author's time in preparing and writing, as well as saves valuable time of learner and avoiding costly misunderstanding. So, in this video, we will focus on four major components of writing effectively. Firstly, establishing the objectives. Secondly, considering the learner. Thirdly, devising the structure. Fourthly, drafting the text, editing and revising. So, firstly, establishing the objectives, because if you do not know where you are going, you will never get there and your learners will never get along with you. So, as an author of self-learning material development, you need to specify the learning outcomes. Secondly, considering the learner. When deciding what to put in a self-learning material, ask one question yourself: what should I put in the minds of learner so that they can use it for its intended purpose? So, as an author of self-learning material development, identify the target group and consider its characteristics. There can be three considerations. Firstly, what they already know affects what you can leave out. Secondly, what they need to know determines what you include. And thirdly, what they want to know suggests the order and emphasis of your writing. Now, you have to devise the structure of self-learning material. For this, you need to organize your idea by carrying out mind mapping or brainstorming. So, write down all main ideas, then list the subordinate ideas below the main ideas and avoid any repetition of ideas. Now, write a first draft, and every unit or every input in a self-learning material is made up of three parts. Firstly, the introduction. This is quite motivating for the learner to know what he is going to learn. Body of the unit must contain several paragraphs, pictures, diagrams, tables, etc. And a conclusion gives the summary of that particular unit. Now, you have to draft the text, edit it and revise it. So, the best way is that keep it aside before you revise, because it will help you view your work objectively and see any gaps or problems. And revising involves rethinking your ideas, refining your arguments, reorganizing paragraphs and rewording sentences. Another technique could be reading your material out loud. In this way, you can identify writing which is awkward or which is not clear. Or you can request your colleague to read the material and obtain valuable feedback from her or him. Now, you have to proofread the final draft. Look for careless errors such as misspelled words, incorrect punctuation, capitalization, etc. The technique could be reading out the material backwards. You can identify the errors, or you can read one line at a time, or you can read long words syllable by syllable. For example, punctuation, okay, this is a long word, and it is very difficult to detect errors on a computer screen. Better you take a printout and check for the misspelled words or incorrect punctuation and capitalization. Now, proofread for clarity. Use easily understandable words. Avoid obscure words. For example, aforementioned. The easily understandable word is already discussed. Supersede. The easily understandable word is replace. Next is avoid abbreviations, acronyms, and jargons. And one more tip is that use verbs in the active voice as compared to passive voice. Check for conciseness. That is, limit paragraph length. It should not contain more than 5 to 6 sentences. Break bigger paragraph into smaller paragraph. Avoid words ending with shun sound. Came to the conclusion. The simple word is concluded or decided. Make revisions. The simple word is revise. Another tip is avoid camouflaged words, where the main emphasis has been camouflaged with the use of unnecessary words. For example, with the exception of. Here the emphasis is on except, and it is camouflaged with the unnecessary words with the shun of. Likewise, for the purpose of discussing, the simple word is discuss. Another tip is omit redundancies, that is unnecessary words. For example, during the year of 2009, simply write during 2009. Needless to say, if it is needless to say, why to say? Likewise, the results so far achieved prove, simply write the results prove, because they have been carried out. And check for accuracy, that is the material which you are including is accurate. You are also including number of tables in a self-learning material. You have to follow some rules for writing the tables. Always have a title including the referent or source of content. There should be subheadings for rows and columns. It should not be very crowded, so limited information in one table. Table on a single page. Table format should be consistent if there are number of tables, and you need to have horizontal lines in the table to set off the headings. One example of a table, the title of the table is Means and Standard Deviations of First Semester Students in Punjab. So there are rows and columns, and all are given certain headings. So this kind of uniformity in preparation of table must be ensured in self-learning material. So dear learners, in this video we have learned how to write effectively in a self-learning material. Thank you very much.